Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the Dean Callan Show. This is Kevin Fever, episode 46. And, today, I did another last minute, like, oh my God, what am I doing? I've got to, like, make it about today, you know, not about cocktails and whatever that could be any day. So, today, being May the 4th, is going to be the Dath Mule Day. Now, I don't know what the Dath Mule is just yet. I do know if I can get my microphone to actually sit on my shirt. Have I got audio? Oh, well, we got it working? Is it working? Nothing seems to be working today. My computers are crashing all over the place. This guy is dying on me. Just wait 1 second. Let me see. And are we working? Boom. Come on, come on, come on. All right, so I know that I want my Dath Mule to be in this mug, my Dath Vader mug. I was originally going to wear a Dath Vader helmet, but it's in storage, and it would have taken me ages to get there and get back, and it didn't really occur to me to do this until kind of too late for that sort of thing. So I'm just going to skip that altogether, and I'm going to come up with what the Dath Mule is on the show. Now, being Star Wars Day, and I love Star Wars, not the last time a Star Wars film came out, but the beginning of the last trilogy, I got so excited about it, thinking it was going to be amazing, that we built a Sarlacc pit. And if you're a Star Wars person, you'd know what a Sarlacc pit is, right? We built a Sarlacc pit punch bowl and sat in here and watched the first six back-to-back in chronological order. I know some people would argue that's not the right way to do it, but we did it. Sitting here drinking Star Wars punch out of a Sarlacc bowl. It was about this big, and it had little teeth all the way in, little Boba Fett. It was pretty cool. It was pretty epic. But I guess my enthusiasm for the films has kind of waned a little bit, especially the last three. But growing up and loving Star Wars, there's a few quotes that kind of helped define who I am today, right? So I'm going to share with you over the course of today's show a couple of those quotes. So let me see. This is my favorite, right? You ready for this?
Always with you, what cannot be done. Hear you nothing that I say? You must unlearn what you have learned.
All right, I'll give it a try.
No, try not. Do or do not. There is no try.
That there is no try thing has stuck with me my whole life. It's one thing to you can attempt to do things and not do them. But if you try to do something and you don't do it, just accept that you didn't do it. You know, like, you try to do it, but you didn't do it. You should accept your failures. That's cool. Like, you either do it or you don't do it. Like, for me, that kind of, I love that so much. You know, try not. There is no try. I love that shit. That's like, Yoda's such a legend. Anyway, this is my label machine. I'm labeling everything. I'm trying to get the whole cabin organized. So today, I'm going to try to figure out what the is a Dath Mule. Originally, I was going to do a Dark and Stormtrooper. But I decided not to do that. So I'm going to start with a big chunk of ice. Let's see. I'm going to do this guy here. See how much space. I haven't done a net volume thing on a Dath Vader mug yet. I have no idea how much volume's in there. I definitely know I want to put some Vestal vodka. Right? I love this shit. So we're going to throw some Vestal vodka in there. I don't know what amount. We'll just say a healthy measure. Right. Sorry, got audio, but it's not the same as usual. Let's see if I can fix that. Boom, boom, boom. Let's see if that's helping at all. I can see on my measurement thing that some of the lights aren't showing up. So, right, so vodka. Now, for me, I would like
I like the aniseediness of this vodka. So I'm gonna like complement the aniseediness with a couple of dashes of absinthe. What have I got here? Now, the next thing I wanna do, I wanna either go a little bit Susie or a bit Fernet. So what do we do? Do we do Gentiany in a mule? Or Fernet? Fuck it. I'm gonna go dark side of the force with the Fernet. Right? About a bar spoon and 3/4 would be my estimation of how much of that there was. Now, I also having when as soon as I said Darth Mule, I thought, shit, I should probably do some ginger syrup, ginger juice, but I didn't really get time. So I'm skipping that. I'm gonna use everyday dry ginger ale because you know what? It's lockdown. How many people have time? You need a centrifugal juicer to do it properly. And how many people have time for that? You know, not that many people. Now, I upgraded my chopping board space over the course of the weekend. You can't see it, but a lot of work went into changing the setup of the cabin. So now, although it's a bit of a mess, instead of standing with the remote control being like, oh, please change, check this out. Overhead, right? You're seeing an overhead view now. Did you see how fast that was? Now, see this guy here, right? This is my new switcher. So I can like switch to different things. If I do auto, right, and I choose dip, hopefully when I switch back to number one, no, I've got the wrong graphics loaded up. But you can see how I've got slow, or I can go straight to bam. And then bam, 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 bam. Right? Do you see that? Pretty stoked about that. Pretty happy about my new switcher. And it doesn't overheat and it doesn't die. So I'm like stoked about that. It feels like I can now get down to concentrating on content and not worry about camera angles. I'm a bit of a geek, I'm not gonna lie. I'll always get caught up on tiny little details like trying to get the camera angles right, trying to get the audio right. Like I literally walked off and just fixed the audio because I couldn't just run knowing that the audio was terrible, right? Now, give this a little mix. Really interesting. It tastes sweet and licoricey. Do Fernet and absinthe like cancel each other out or something? Why is it so sweet? Well, I'm gonna have to make another one of these. I might actually do the same thing but with a dark and stormy-esque. I don't have proper ginger beer. Electra, if you're watching this, could you bring in ginger beer? Even the kombucha ginger beer? That'd be super awesome. Anyway, moving on. Of all the things I've seen on social media today, and like, I'm a person that will watch out for Star Wars related stuff. The reason for that, actually, there's a good point. A long time ago, many, many moons, myself and Zach, who was a brand ambassador, Zachary Connor de Git or de Jit, legit, I don't know. Zach and I decided that it was a great idea. I had this idea that if you're a small brand, right, you're a tiny brand, you're starting to sell your own mugs, right? Not these kind of mugs, these would be easy to sell. You're trying to sell your own mugs. In this case, we were trying to sell Monkey Shoulder. And we wanted to keep. With the minimum possible spend, we wanted to keep our brand in the minds of people. So if we run an event, we wanted to keep them thinking about our brand long after we'd finished with it. Oh, yes! Thank you! Okay, we wanted to keep people thinking about our brands long after, look at this, kombucha ginger beer. I just remembered that we had that inside. Thank you, baby. Anyway. This is the best thing ever. She actually brought it up, which means my wifey's watching. Right, so we wanted to keep our brand in the minds of people. And I had this idea that, right, we could get sued, but what if we throw parties that are Star Wars themed about 6 months before the Star Wars franchise starts gearing up for their next film release? So it'd be the same thing as, like, if you were about to, you knew, you're a geek, you know that stage four or whatever it is of the Avengers franchise is about to kick off. And you know Disney's going to plow money into that, right? Or it could be there's a new Iron Man film coming out in 8 months. And you know that 6 months before they're going to market the shit out of it. You have an Iron Man party, right? You're not doing anything wrong. You're just doing themed stuff. And then everybody, like, they have a great night. You throw, put on some drinks, you put on some music. Everyone has a great night. And then for the every time they see this Iron Man film marketing, they're thinking about Monkey Shoulder. We did that with Star Wars and we called it Darth Funk. And you know Daft Punk have like the two helmets. We had like half a Stormtrooper, half a Darth Vader helmet. It was pretty cool. We did like a DJ set where I was dressed as Darth Vader, which was a big mistake. This is a failure of mine. Are you ready for this? Look, here is something new. Wait, ready? I don't know why the black box was there. Anyway, huge failure of mine was that Zach was a stormtrooper dressed in a white suit with a white helmet, and I was Darth Vader in a black suit with a black helmet. Problem is, Darth Vader's like 8 foot tall, and Zach is way taller than me. So when we did the event, Darth Vader was shorter than the stormtrooper. It just didn't look right. And also, if you're ever planning to DJ in a busy bar, we were at 28 Hong Kong Street in Singapore when we did this. If you ever plan to DJ in a busy bar, don't wear a Darth Vader helmet. Like, the helmet was a screen accurate, giant, big, huge helmet, right? From inside that helmet, you can't hear anything. It's just an echo. So you're trying to mix music, but you can't hear anything. He couldn't hear either. So we just took the helmets off eventually and gave up on it. But it was super epic. Now, today, I seen my favorite thing of all time on the TikTok, right? The TikTok. I feel old if I go on TikTok. But someone slightly older than me, I think, looks younger, but I'm pretty sure he's older, is all over the TikTok thing, right? So Des, he puts a Star Wars themed TikTok up today, and I thought it was epic. I stole it, and I'm going to play it for you now. It's super fun, right? You ready? Boom.
Canteen, yeah? There must have been a cafeteria downstairs in between battles where Darth Vader could just chill and go down. I will have the penne a la Arrabbiata. You'll need a tray.
Do you know who I am?
Do you know who I am?
This is not a game of who the fuck are you. For I am Vader. Darth Vader. Lord Vader. I can kill you with a single thought.
We'll still need a tray.
No, I will not need a tray. I do not need a tray to kill you. I can kill you without a tray, with the power of the force, which is strong within me. Even though I could kill you with a tray if I so wished. For I would hack at your neck with the thin bit until the blood flowed across the canteen floor.
No, the food is hot. You'll need a tray to put the food on.
Oh, I see the food is hot. I'm sorry. I did not realize.
How good is that? He's so good. Anyway, I thought that was super creative. I loved it. Made me giggle loads. So, Mitch's Minute today. Honestly, I've just finished it on this, editing it, because I edit on this computer and send it to that one. I don't know why. I guess I've just been doing that since the beginning. I should probably put it all on the same computer, but had I done that, I wouldn't have been able to finish it. So I'm going to leave that towards the end because I really can't load it in. Oh, maybe I can. Yeah! Des, dude, that video was my favorite thing ever. I probably should have asked your permission to share it, but I figured you put it on the public spectrum. Like, it's on TikTok. People can see it. made me laugh so much. I absolutely loved it. Anyway, moving forward, what else are we going to talk about? I had a whole list of things and then everything melted down. I got to get better at this. I'm so bad at this. Also, I can't even see my little man. Yeah. All right. These aren't loading up properly, but I'll tell you what I'm going to do. I am going to make another drink just off the top of my head. And was it the Harry Palmer cocktail? I've been drinking them all weekend. They're super amazing. So I'm kind of inspired to make another, like a Darth Vader-esque, what would the Dark Lord drink? Manhattan variation, right? We're going to stick to rye. I'm going to get Willet back down again. Oh, love this stuff. Right, I've still got some Martini Gran Lusso left because we haven't been drinking this. We've been drinking the normal martini inside the house. Yeah, mate, Mitch, I have no idea what is going on here, man. But like, I'm going to try to load up Mitch's Minute live. See if it works. Whatever. If it doesn't work, it doesn't work. Right, so. So I'm just going to go all the dark things, I think. You know, inspired by the Harry Palmer, I'm going to add bitters still. I'm going to do two bitters. I like things extra bitter. Right. So no, actually, I'm going to go Sue's Orange Bitters and Angostura. That's what I'm going to do. Yeah, this is going to be bitter. Right. So I'm using Riga Black Balsam Liqueur, which is like a kind of black cherry liqueur-ish type of thing. It's a little bit sweet, but which kind of leads me to think it's kind of like more of a twist on a jockey club. But who cares? Whatever. We're just making it up. And I know it's going to taste nice. In my brain, it says, this tastes nice. My brain is saying, Dean, this is going to taste delicious. You're going to love this. Right. No, mixing. Ah, there we are. What a mess. I spent like 10 minutes trying to get a video to play and it wouldn't play. Right, so two dashes of Angostura bitters. It looks like three, but the first one was kind of not a good dash. One, two of Sue's Orange bitters. And sticking, not going to stick to the same formula as Alice. I'm going to go, where is it? A quarter of an ounce or 7.5 mils of this Riga Black Cherry. Then I'm going to do 1 ounce or 30 mils of Gran Lusso. Oh, Gran Lusso. So nice. Right, put this one straight back in the fridge where it belongs. Some would argue these days that it doesn't need to go in the fridge. Well, you use a lot of vermouth. I'm still putting mine in the fridge. And a double of Willet straight rye whiskey at 55% ABV, bottle 93 of 204 bottles. They only made 204 bottles of this. Wow. Now look at me consuming it. Right, so for those of you who have been watching the show, kind of like Remember the Main, exactly. It's basically like, mate, this is all the same stuff. Mitch recorded the whole video in slow-mo. That's why Mitch's Minute wouldn't send to me. So like, we had that issue. We missed out on Mitch's Minute a little bit. I've found a way to make it work. He sent me a second video. So I'm going to try to make that video work. Now for stirring, I'm going to use some of my shaking ice for stirring. Right, so last week I had an idea, right? And that idea was, what if we all have a drink together? Because it's feeling kind of lonely in here. Like, Electra, my wife, is working like really hard. So she can't come out here every single, time I do the show. She's always working. And her mum takes care of Axel while I'm out here doing the show. So Axel can't be out here. You know, it's not a fair environment for him to be in. If he wants to play, then we've got to play. You know, I'm not going to have him sit there and be ignored. That's not how I treat my son. So I figure let's have a drink together. Now, virtually have a drink together. So I found a solution. And this Friday will be the first day that we're going to do it. For the first attempt, sorry, Mitch and Gabby, I can't really afford out of my own pocket to post stuff outside of... I looked up how much it was going to cost to post like a couple of packets internationally, and it was like looking at 70, 80 pounds and stuff, whereas within the UK it's like 10 to 20 pounds. So for a couple of people in the UK, let's test it in the UK first. If I could get some support from someone to do one where they just post a miniature internationally and we all have the same thing, great. But for now, this week, I'm going to try to aim for us to all do a tasting together on Friday. And what we're going to taste is this guy here. The Plantation Rum Isle of Fiji. The Fiji Island one. Double aged rum, you know, like, you know, the whole thing. They age it there and then they bring it to France and they age it in France, as far as I understand. Right? Isle of Fiji. This is some new shit that we're going to taste. You can make that out, right? Let me change the angle. Ooh, look at that, Isle of Fiji. And look, that's it from the top. Ooh, right? There you go. So Isle of Fiji, what I'm gonna do, this is how I'm gonna roll it. I am gonna get these little guys here. These are the sample bottles I'm using for my consultancy. And I am gonna decant some of this into some of those, and then I'm gonna put them into these. Can you see that? Right, look at this. Wait, let me try a close up. Ooh. That was a Dink Allen Show bubble wrap thing, right? Put that in there, bam, can post it out to you. Hopefully it'll be there before Friday. I'm gonna do a couple of things. You won't know what the other things are. You'll know this, won't know what the other things are. And then we'll all have a couple of drams together. They won't be big drams for social responsibility purposes, but all in all, if it works, it works. And Friday, we taste some new stuff. So if you're up for that, let me know. I know Daniel Kaizen and I think Dez were super up for it last time. And Diogo, if I can get something to Portugal, I will. But yeah, rock and roll. In the future, I mean, Diogo. Next time, maybe, when I figure this out. Okay, so. Oh. That's a big glass, huh? I mean, like 60, 30, almost 10, maybe 30, 40 dilution. That's still nowhere near filling the glass. What's that glass for? Right, I'm actually gonna put a lemon twist on this. I always put an orange twist. Today, I'm gonna do a very light lemon twist. I think lemon kind of crashes up against that cherry. A little bit for aroma. Now, just because Mitch, I think no coupe would be complete without like a big chunk of ice in there. I mean, you need to put a big chunk of ice in there, right? Oh, jokes. I think I'd be disowned by Mitch if I did that after his Mitch's Minute on Friday. Wow, okay. Fuck, that's really drinkable. It's mouthwateringly drinkable. This stuff, I don't know how many people have tried this, but it's really good and it's working really well with the rye. So to read this out, Riga Limited Edition Black Balsam Balsams. It says cursed cherry. On the back, it says a whole bunch of what I believe is Latvian stuff. I got this from a Latvian friend of mine. But yeah, so to give you an idea of what it tastes like by itself, my best memory of it was it was kind of a sweet cherry liqueur, almost, in its flavor. All right, so you get cherry straight away. Almost cherry hearing, okay? Basically, the flavor is like, imagine cherry hearing, but strip away some of that viscosity, strip away some of that sweetness, and give it like a tartness that you don't get with the cherry hearing. It's kind of like a sharper, drier version of cherry hearing. Mm. Close up of this one. Mate, Des, when this is all over, just come hang out. That's the close up. Ooh, 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 ooh. Yeah. Boom. Right, there we go. So that's that. It's actually really tasty. It's really tasty. We should do a comparison of cherry hearing versus that stuff. I lost the Darth Vader theme. I'm kind of tempted, like, can you imagine if these little guys were my guests and I was giving them little tiny drinks, right? Anyway, losing my mind now. Right, so let's try to load up Mitch's minute. I'll give you these guys for a minute.
There you go, let's hack it. All right, what have we got? One. There you go, let's hack it. All right, what have we got? One thing you'd like to see go away in bartending. All right, the trend I'd like to see go away is people take themselves less seriously, but that's too long a thing to talk about. So I'm going to stall.
No, it didn't seem to work. So, that's a real shame. That is actually a real shame, because I was looking forward to that. Right, so here, little wise word from Yoda about failure.
Heeded my words not, did you? Pass on what you have learned. Strength, mastery, but weakness, folly, failure also. Yes, failure most of all. The greatest teacher, failure is. We are what they grow beyond. That is the true burden of all masters.
Right? One of the biggest things, like, in my career that I learned was that when we make mistakes, we shouldn't try to hide it. We should try to look at our mistakes and see why we're making them, look at our weaknesses and make ourselves stronger from them. There was a quote that Don Lee put out recently about, you know, it's not our strengths that make us, somewhere along the line, it's not our strengths that make us great, it's our weaknesses, like focusing on our weaknesses and making those better, make us better. Look, something along those lines. Anyway, because I've failed so much, and honestly, this show, none of the gadgets failed. I think this is the first time, well, apart from the computers obviously freezing and not letting us send things to each other, this is the first time all the gadgets didn't fail, which is kind of a win. So, if you're interested in tasting the rum with me on Friday, let me know if you're based locally in the UK, and I'll send them up to you. And, you know, until then, if I can have one last attempt, let's try one more time to see if we can get between two computers Mitch's Minute to work, because I really want you to see Mitch's Minute. I really want you to see Mitch's Minute. I can't help it. Right, so.
The importance of awards in our industry. Lol. no way. You know what though? We did in an effort to get my staff back to work or working in some sense. We opened the bar at Grand Blanco that I run in Venice, and we had a window open, and we were doing takeaway cocktails, and we had a menu. We had some DIY kits, obviously beer and wine, some bougie spirits, some of the harder stuff. Yeah, and we were doing cocktails to order, and I bartended the first session, or the first day on the Friday. We made 290 drinks in 4 hours, and I did it with plastic gloves and a mask on. And I'm willing to say that's one of the hardest shifts I've ever done. Like, bartending with a mask on, even without guests being able to get that close to you, is just unbelievably hard. Our future is going to be very, very interesting.
Thank you, Mitch. The awards thing, right? Like, obviously, awards are great. I've never won any awards, I don't think. I think I've won competitions, but I've never won awards. And I still feel great about myself. I feel like I've accomplished stuff. But at the same time, it does. Maybe they're the most competitive people. It does kind of feel like there's a small group that constantly get more attention in that area. And for that reason, I think as of maybe next week, having traveled around the world and met a lot of people in my time, and I know a lot of people that are very talented that you might not know, I'm going to go out of my way to contact as many people that I think are awesome around the world and just chat shit with them. It might take 10 minutes out of the show, might take 15. If I have to just cut the whole conversation short so the show's not crazy long, I'll put the longer conversation on the YouTube channel. But I think it'd be pretty cool for me to introduce the people I know around the world to you guys, even if there's, I can't even see how many people are watching, but I think that would be a really cool thing to do. So if you're already friends with me, and if you're not, like, cool, rock and roll, like, get in touch. If you want to put yourself out there, you're more than welcome. Otherwise, I'm going to be calling all my friends, calling in favors and being like, let's chat about what's going on in Melbourne. Let's chat about what's going on in Sydney. Let's chat about what's going on in Shanghai, China. Let's chat about what's going on in LA, what's happening in New York. Give people a sense of what's going on around the world, where people are sitting, where their mindset's at, and what they're doing to make things better. Anyway, this has been the Dean Callan Show. I hope you've enjoyed it. Sorry for the mess that was not putting the content together properly. But not tomorrow, Wednesday. Wednesday. I've got a great show for you Wednesday. I think if I can get him on the phone, I'm going to hit up Samuel about some mead. So if any of you know what that means, then great. If you don't, oh, wait. I'll see you Wednesday. Yeah, I'll see you Wednesday. If I can't get Samuel on the phone about mead, then I'm going to hit up someone else about twuck. So if there's anyone watching that knows what twuck is, great. If you'd prefer that over the mead, you need to comment now. Otherwise, we'll put the mead off till next week and, you know, whatever, we'll figure it out. I need a sign off. I need a There needs to be a sign-off button, like...
Heeded my words not, did you? Bastard.